Hi guys, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Monster Hunter Portable 3 for PSP. And as you can see, this is my main character Lucy, and I have taken the time to make the Falmer set for you. I kind of want to redeem myself for yesterday when I thought that the Bnahabra set had wings, and it didn't. It's the Falmer set that has wings, so now you know what I was confused about. And I can go to sleep tonight without being too bothered about it. And yeah, I also cut in this part where I gather herbivore eggs. This is how you get them rather easily. They are at the dunes in area 7. You get 1000 points for delivering one egg, and it doesn't take that long. So it's 1000 points. It's great to gather these, but there usually only are like one or two per quest. But it's well worth getting. So this is, of course, as you probably noticed already, post recording or post commentary, and I am pretty comfortable here. Oh, this video will be hard to do. I am rather boring usually, but this one, oh. As you can see, I got a Yagi up in my ass. He's coming around the corner, and I am pretty stressed out right now. Ooh, that was exciting. I didn't make it though. Just to spoil this for you, I made it. You kind of want to watch out so that the stamina bar don't go down to zero, because then you will drop the egg and it will all be wasted. Ooh, so after this we are doing Barroth. And I really wanted to do live commentary that I should have done, but since I knew I was gonna cut in some stuff, I didn't. Oh yeah, I also killed a Kirupeko. The second one was also possible to record, but I didn't want to show all that video, so I show it here real fast. You can see that the beak is broken. That is how it looks, and both wings are broken. You can see that the claws are missing. Okay, so Barroth. There are plenty of time to talk about Barroth, because this is a rather long fight. He has pretty much health, and I have a pretty bad weapon. I have put decorations in to get attack up medium. As you can see, it is attack decorations. I can show right here, fast. That's where you create, and as you can see, attack UL 1. You need some Yagi scales to make them. It's pretty easy. So what am I doing? I think I am upgrading the sword and shield a bit. Oh, I'm upgrading the gear. Yeah, that's about time. I kinda want to upgrade your gear as far as possible. I'm also a bit low on cash, so I am going to sell around 400 might seeds I have been farming. And that is probably just above 50,000 C, whatever C is, like Yukimo points, cash. Just about 50,000. That will keep us going for a while, until the next level where we probably get armor and might chant. It's called chant. Oh, it's stuff you put in your inventory to get stronger. They are expensive. get them rather early in this game. And the bad part to upgrade those in Freedom Unite, you only had to kill that crab. Oh, it was easy. I do have videos of it, but I only called them the crab. You probably know which one I mean. He's not an Elder Dragon, but he is huge. And you've got to get his claws and like... Yeah, it's charm, man. Charm, chant, charm. Ah. You kind of combine those claws and the items and you get a better version. In this game, the better version is Devil Yo. Oh, it's so much harder. So much harder. Just... when Devil Yo comes. I have fucking nightmares at night. Okay, so I kinda did the cat skills there real fast as well. I didn't have much points earlier, so it wasn't, and it wasn't actually needed. They don't get the skills until they get back from a mission, and I'm not sure if you got to enter your home, but when you enter your home, you will get a notification that they have learned those skills. I think it's the same with the farm. Well, they probably learn them anyway, but they will not have them this time. So, off to the Barroth. Oh yeah, there is a Ludroth quest here as well. I was thinking of doing that Ludroth instead of the normal, but it would take too long since that is a four-man monster. It's kind of funny when you do the single play quest and then you get to the multiplayer part and you solo, you get so much money and you get so much stuff from the boxes and ooh, it's total resupply. And then you get I needed help with HR6 to get to HR6. Apart from that, I got pretty much most of HR5 solo. And I am not sure if there is anything about after HR6. I've heard that there is no G rank. So, I'm not really gonna comment about that because I see that there is a commendation G. But I do not know how to get that. Lagombi. I've already recorded Lagombi. So, what am I doing now? I don't remember. Yeah, changing weapon. You kind of want a weapon with good reach on Barroth. Sure, the sword and shield is great, but it's not really great on Barroth if you want to cut his tail. Otherwise, it is good. As good as any other, but if you want to cut his tail, it's so high up. Very high up. No blue mushroom. Oh, I got 159 blue mushroom. Not needed. I usually buy my stuff, by the way. It's easier than to farm it. I recommend you also check that vendor and kinda buy a couple of stacks of what you need. Then you will be set for a good while. Maybe not in the beginning. Not too soon when you want gear and that kind of stuff. Then it's kinda hard to get those extra cash. But when you got the stuff you want and it's rather hard and you're farming and then just buy. You will get the cash back eventually. Might seeds. Did I sell those might seeds? I probably did. I didn't check. Ooh, paying attention isn't my strong side. Okay, that's a white cat. You don't have to worry about white cats. You can do Felvin bombs on monsters and yourself. You will get attacked of cats or the monster, so don't get hit yourself. And this is where the Barroth starts, in Area 3. Anyway, there are also black cats. Black cats are horrible. They will steal all your stuff, and I am not kidding. You let them be, and they hit you, they can steal like your map, bombs, potions, book of combos. Anything you have in the inventory, they can take from you. Then you gotta hit them really fast to get it back. Okay, so let's talk about the Barroth while I'm kinda jumping around and hitting its tail. The Barroth is weak to both water and fire, and water is when it's muddy, you can see the mud on him. And fire is when it's not muddy, and it's more muddy than it's not, in my opinion, or my experience. Experience is a better word for what I wanted to tell. Anyway, it's more often muddy. So if you want a specific element against this guy, then take water. It take a lot of elemental damage on its head, but it's kind of want a hammer or something if you're going to. Maybe the great sword can cut through that fat head of his. The small weapons will just bounce. You might want impact weapon to break the skull. It's rather hard with a katana. You kind of bounce and then you're open for an attack and just run over. If you are persistent, you might make it. But if you have like water fire, the head is where it will take most elemental damage. It's also pretty weak to ice if you listen to Wikia. You can use ice weapon, but I don't think we got access to any ice weapons yet. Do we? I think we have been in the Thundra. You really want to mine in the Thundra to get Isium or Ithium. You will use that for ice weapons, as it sounds. So, what else? Kinda shake his body to throw mud around him, and if you get the mud on you, you can either run to your cat. And if you got a kind cat, unlike me, you got like two assholes. Then they will hit you. And you will get rid of them. You are safe underneath its body, but not underneath its tail. Cleanser removes the mud. If you play multiplayer, try to keep an eye out for your buddy if he get mud on him, and you can like get him out of it real fast by swinging a couple of strikes. Barroth also gets very fast when enraged. It's like tripling his speed, especially on high rank. That's really fast. It's pretty much the same in ultimate. Yeah, that's pretty much his main move, is that charge. He kinda home in a little bit on you, and it's a bit tricky to avoid in the beginning. So, apart from the head, which isn't really a great place to hit him, his like butt and hands is his weak spot. So if you hit him there, you will finish him pretty fast, no matter what weapon you have. You can break his face, cut off his tail, and you can break his claws on his little hands. So we mainly moves between area 3, 4 and 2, but occasionally he can go to area 8. It doesn't happen very often though, it's mostly when you're kinda after another monster and you get a Barroth at the same time, then he's happy to follow you around. Tail swipe, the horrible, horrible tail swipe. I'm kinda reckless at this one, I give a lot of potions. You don't really need mega potions in the beginning. Some people don't even need it later on, but it helps. There you saw I bounced and then it got me like a headbang. Headbash. Oh, my throat. I'm sorry that this video isn't very great. The fight with Barroth isn't that exciting. He can follow you around pretty well when he gets fast. It's like up your ass. Yeah. That was his tail. It's pretty easy, especially low rank. It's a bit harder on high rank, of course, but not that hard if you focus on cutting it off. So now I kind of want to get his claws. Get another monster, like a Yagi or something. Look at the cat. What is that? Is that like a taunt? It looks like it must be a taunt. At first I did not know what he did, but I think he actually get a bit of attention, more attention from the monster when he does that, so maybe I should be grateful for him just standing around playing air guitar. Yeah, and the boomerang is great. If you get an impact weapon on your cat and it does boomerang, it will do impact damage, so it can stun like Kelby and Anteka. You will have no problem gathering horns if you get boomerang cats with impact weapons. I can guarantee that. And if you get slash weapons, they can actually cut off tails with the boomerangs. Rarely see that happen though. Very rare. So I kinda messed up this fight a little, it's taking way longer than it probably would, but exploit weaknesses. I think I could have gotten a water katana. I should probably have gone and done that one before. But I am doing the Luderoth later, and you get water stuff from Luderoth. When you get up, it's a bit annoying if you start your combination, because he will like be behind you. So He goes to number 3 to sleep and recover and also get mud. You can see where he goes in the ground. It's a small cloud. He doesn't jump up under you like some other bosses. It's nothing to worry about. Safest place under him. Just keep hitting him in the balls or butt or whatever that is. And he will die. If you hit him like in the legs a lot, he will trip over and get some free hits. Oh, that face! Oh, this is not one of my favorites, especially not when I formed this on my other character. Wasn't that fun, to be honest. Oh, that wasn't fair. That was in a bad position. You see that if you hit him in the face, you still cut through, but if you hit him in his giant forehead, then you kind of bounce off. But I do think he takes the most damage if you actually manage to cut him in the face. Mud again. Mud! Okay, so we should be dead around now. I'm a bit surprised he is still alive. That is my sucky performance. Oh, a counterattack. You can do counterattacks in this game. It's pretty hard. Usually it happens just randomly. You kinda would have been owned otherwise, but you get that strike in perfectly and you do a counter-attack. So, that was Barroth. There are a couple of minutes left. I think that would be us checking out what's next and... what was it? I think it was... the guts, the monster guts. I think that is the next video. That was the Barroth. You shouldn't have any problems with him at this rank, and when you are at a high rank you won't have much problem either. It's pretty much the same, except he does like a charge, another charge, like a long charge, lasts a few seconds running around. You get fertile mud from Barroth and you should not use that for farming. Don't use it for farming. You can, but don't. Unless you got like a large overflow, because it is used for gear and decorations. And it's a bit hard to come over. Okay, so we are at the end of this video. If you like this video, please rate, comment and subscribe. Thank you for watching and see you next time.